Centuries ago, a prophet brought God's message to the people of Mecca. While many treated his words lightly, a young man in a distant land thirsted for such truth, but he was trapped in darkness.
Thank you, Tarba.
Oh, Salman, I am so sorry you're lonely.
Not lonely, empty. There must be something more out there, something more meaningful than keeping these flames. I have to find it.
Nothing is more meaningful than tending the holy flames of Zarathustra.
I'm sorry, Father, I didn't mean... But there must be something more.
Perhaps a diversion would help you see things more clearly. Today, you shall handle matters of my estate. Now, listen, Salman. There's no way I can bring the harvest in on time. See if you can solve it.
Thanks, Father. I'll do my best.
He'll see that life outside is filled with difficulties which he cannot begin to comprehend. By evening, he'll be back at the fire.
So what do you think? Will it work? Or have I made a terrible fool of myself?
No! It will work! In all my years here, I never thought to try something like this. Neither did your father, I might add.
I knew you'd be back, Salman, when you saw how difficult and dark that...
I've never answered so many questions.
I knew there had to be something more than feeding meaningless flames. What else can you tell me?
I am afraid we don't have all the answers. But there is a man, an honorable one, who could teach you more. But...
What?
He's very far away, beyond all the deserts and mountains you've ever heard of.
I don't care. I'll go anywhere.
It's not an easy life. There's no luxury, only work, study, service.
That's all I've ever longed for. I'm going.
How could you allow these holy flames to die?
Father, I can no longer worship flames created by my own hands. I want to worship my creator.
Blasphemy!
I'm sorry, Father. I will miss you, but I must follow what I must follow.
Yes, you must.
Father, you can't do this, please! No!
Salman, the Honorable One, he wishes to see you.
Is he?
He says it's the end.
Salman, my son. Dear Salman.
Don't leave me now, Master. I still haven't found what I'm searching for.
Now, listen to me. It is written that a prophet is coming. You shall know him by these signs. He shall preach the religion of Ibrahim, and he shall come from Arabia.
Arabia?
Yes. He shall have the seal of prophecy and be driven from his home to a new place, filled with palms, between two tracks of lava. And lastly, he will eat of a gift, but not if it be given as alms.
Master, I have to...
I know. Go, Salman.
What's this?
Money falling into our pockets, I think.
Come and join us, friend. You must be thirsty.
Wait for my word.
Get our friend some water.
Thank you.
That's it, boy. Take a good long drink.
Now sit. Sit, my friend, and tell us where you're from.
The great Persia.
So far from home. Your family misses you, I'm sure.
Oh, they don't know where I am. No one does.
Alone in the world.
Ah. Oh, I'm headed to Arabia.
And what takes you to Arabia?
A prophet of God. It's a journey I started long ago, but I think it's finally coming to an end. And the prophecy also says that this man won't accept food if it's offered as alms to the poor.
It all sounds very interesting, but I'm sorry to say, boy, you're a fool. A fool to leave your father's palace. A fool to follow prophets. And a fool to fall in with thieves. Slave traders, to be more precise.
Walking alone at night. One of those filthy Oz.
Your kind would know about filth, wouldn't you? Oh.
Let go, Bara! He's an owl!
Go.
You stupid... Do you know how many times they've attacked us in the streets?
As many times as we've attacked them. Someone has to have the courage to stop fighting.
Oh, listen to you. You think you're some kind of angel messenger ever since you joined that peace lover Mohammed.
If you'd listen to his words, you'd understand. He is a prophet.
What a horrible place.
We'll only be here long enough to find a good slave.
We don't need a slave, Father. It's not right.
I've heard enough of your compassionate nonsense, son. Some men are born slaves.
Stop! I'm not a slave! I'm the son of Manwa of Persia! Let me go!
Here's a pair of strong ones. Make a bid, men.
5 dinars for the Persian there.
Now our only hope is the Prophet.
Prophet?
Muhammad. He says all are equal in God's eyes, so his followers buy freedom for the slaves.
This Muhammad, what does he teach? Does he teach?
The Gospel of Ibrahim.
Where is he? Is he here?
No. He lives in Mecca, even though the leaders hate him.
Then he could be driven out. And tell me, would this Muhammad ever accept food that was intended as alms for the poor?
Muhammad lives to feed the poor himself.
Where is Mecca? How can I...
Soul!
Please! I found him, please! Please, I must find out if he's the Prophet. Please, let me go. Let me go.
Hey, slave. There it is. Your new home.
He shall be driven from his home to a new place, filled with palms, between 2 tracks of lava.
Oh, this is it. Someday the Prophet will come here.
Fool! There will be no Prophet!
But there will. Please, you must understand this. For your own sake. Because when he comes, everything will change.
No one will ever change this. That I am your master until you draw your last breath.
In Mecca, life was difficult for the Prophet. Peace and blessing be upon him. His wife died. And then, soon after, his uncle and protector, Abu Talib, died as well. The situation for the Muslims and their leader was desperate. Some distance from Mecca, Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, went to Taif to deliver his message and invite them to become Muslims. He was accompanied by Zayd.
You expect me to believe that you are a prophet? You want my people to give up their gods for your new way?
Ow! Stone this man, children of Taif! Drive him from our city!
No! Stop it!
Are you all right?
The Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, offered this prayer to God. O God, please consider my weakness, my shortness of means, and the little esteem that people have of me. O most merciful God, you are the Lord of the oppressed, and you are my Lord. To whom would you leave my fate? To a stranger who insults me, or to an enemy who dominates me? There is neither power nor strength, except in you.
Come. I'll help you home.
They tell me you're sympathetic to the owls.
I am sympathetic to peace.
Liar! He doesn't care if one of his own gets cut down on the street.
And you don't care if the streets are filled with orphans, so long as you're left standing in the end.
Peace!
Yes, peace. Peace before we choke to death on our own pride. There is a delegation leaving from this city. We're going to get Muhammad. He's the only man who can heal this city.
A delegation of 72 Muslims has arrived from Yathrib. They wish to meet you.
Messenger of God, please. Say you'll come to Yathrib. Our city is filled with bloodshed, brother fighting brother. Only you and your message can bring peace. Say you'll come. If you do, we promise to protect and defend you.
Heaven has opened a door, O messenger of God.
Yamin! Cousin Yamin! That man they call the prophet, that Muhammad, is coming to Yathrib! A delegation from Yathrib begged him to come. He's in Cuba tonight, but he'll be here tomorrow.
It makes no difference to me.
But they say he'll become Yathrib's leader.
And you should see him.
Poor as an empty pocket.
You see, it's happening. Everything is changing just as I told you it would. The prophecy is being fulfilled.
Not another word. I'll show you. No food or water for 2 days.
Watch what you say about this, Muhammad. My father will make you pay for it.
I'm told that many are waiting to receive you at Yathrib, O messenger of God.
It's true.
I've waited so long to. I have some bread here. I offer it to you as alms for the poor.
Don't be offended, my friend. The prophet...
I know. The true prophet will not partake of alms.
I have found you. O messenger of God, I have found you.
I'll make you beg for the days of simple slavery, Salman. Now get to work! What's happening?
Father, you won't believe this. Everyone wanted Muhammad to stay with them, so we let his camel loose. Where the camel stops, that's where he's going to stay.
Shrewd man. No one could be offended at the choice of a camel.
Here the prophet will stay, and here we will build our first place of worship.
There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his prophet.
There is no God but God, and Muhammad is his prophet.
Have all these people become Muslims?
There is no God but God,
and Muhammad is his prophet.
There is no God but God, and Muhammad is his prophet.
And so they came, one by one, to say, there is no God but God, and Muhammad is his prophet.
No God but God.
And he renamed Yathrib, the city of the prophet, El Medina.
Set me free.
Salman.
Let me go to him.
But my father.
I promise I'll return. I must let him know I believe.
They say the Meccans have stolen the goods we left behind. I think... it's Salman, the Persian slave.
Messenger of God, I will never be with you. As a slave, I have accepted this. But I have risked everything to tell you. I wanted you to know that I know that there is no God but Allah, and you are his prophet.
The mosque is finished.
It is. The Muslims go there 5 times a day to pray. There are so many of them now.
Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah.
Things have finally changed. Muhammad has written a constitution. It says that everyone, not just the Muslims, will live in peace and worship just how they want to. There's been a great battle at Badr. The Meccans had the Muslims outnumbered 3-1, but the Muslims won. And listen to this. Muhammad won't let the prisoners be mistreated. In fact, if a Meccan teaches 10 Muslims to read, he's set free. The Meccans are coming again. They just won't leave the Muslims alone. It looks like war. We'll meet them at the mountain of Uhud. The Muslims were winning at first, but then the archers disobeyed the Prophet and left their hill. So that let the Meccans attack from behind. Was almost killed. But he survived.
Oh, how I long to be with them. I'd give anything to pray with them, to fight with them, to die with them. Name the price for my freedom.
Back your stable, Salman.
I want to know the price of my freedom.
Oh, you thought your God would save you, eh? Thought your faith would set you free? All right, here's your price. 300 date palms and 40 pieces of gold.
A city can be bought for that price.
And you won't be sold for a piece of gold or a palm shoot less. I guess Muhammad didn't change everything, did he, slave?
What is this?
My freedom. Messenger of God.
Salman's search was over. He had finally found the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, and was free to follow. Later, when 10,000 Meccans came to assault Medina, the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, called Ashura and asked for the opinion of his companions. Salman calmly stood and offered an idea.
In Persia, when we feared attack led by horsemen, we dug a trench around us. Could we not dig a trench around this city?
The Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, instantly saw the wisdom of this idea. Salman engineered, supervised, and did much of the work. It was completed just in time and successfully kept the Meccans out of Medina until a mighty sandstorm drove them away. This victory marked the end of the Meccan Wars and opened a door for the Muslims' return to Mecca and the Holy Kaaba. Salman al-Farisi is remembered today as a devoted follower and companion of the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him.